channel. If you're new here, welcome, welcome. Make sure to subscribe and also to turn on the notification bell so you can get notified every time that I put out a new video. All right, so today we're going to be talking about how I prepared for my successful VBAC. When I put out my VBAC story, I did get a lot of people asking me what I did to prepare for it. And so I decided to make a video just to explain what I did or what I didn't do and all that stuff that, you know, went on behind the scenes. So before I dive into it, I just want to give you guys two pieces of advice first. The first advice would be the advice my doctor gave to me that, you know, she supports VBAC 100%. She's all for it. However, she advises that you only try it if you go into labor naturally. If you have to be induced for it, then she would not recommend you do a VBAC. But if you go into labor, your water breaks or doesn't break, just so long as you go into labor naturally, then you can go ahead and do the VBAC. Second advice is you're not obligated to tell the whole world your plans. You don't have to tell everybody that you know that, oh, I'm trying to do a VBAC or I'm trying to have, you know, my baby vaginally after my first was a C-section. Because the last thing you need is people, you know, trying to put more fear in you, because I mean, there is that little bit of a risk or whatever, but the last thing you need is people just, you know, adding to the fear that you probably already have and just, you know, giving you negative advice or just the kind of vibe that you do not need. So you're not under any obligation to tell anybody about your plans. You can just keep it to yourself and your husband and, you know, yeah. So in preparing for VBAC, I didn't do anything physically to prepare for it. So I wasn't like exercising a certain amount of day, you know, a certain amount of times per day or anything like that. So physically, honestly, there isn't really anything that I did to prepare for it. Everything that I did was more so emotional and, you know, mentally, spiritually. And so those are the tips that I'm going to be sharing with you guys. So the first thing that I did to prepare was to read Supernatural Birth by Jackie Mize. Well, I didn't exactly read it. I had an audiobook version. So I listened to it and it was a game changer for me. I feel like after I listened to it, that's when I got that motivation. That's when I got that courage to desire, you know, VBAC, to want to try things naturally. And so that book did a lot for me. It gave me so much confidence. It gave me, you know, so much knowledge about things that I didn't know when it came to birth and how women were built for it and all that stuff that goes into it, and a lot of encouragement from it, because she does, you know, give you scriptures that are in relation to childbirth and child rearing and, you know, promises in that area. And so it was a really good resource for me, and that was what I feel like set things in motion for me to, you know, start preparation for VBAC. The next thing that I did to prepare was to have a strong support system. So obviously I didn't make this baby all by myself, and so I made sure that I told my husband my desires and my plan, and it was so great that he supported it and he was all for it. You know, he was like, yeah babe, go for it, I am here with you 100%. And so make sure you have that support system, at least in your spouse. You don't have to tell, like I said, you don't have to tell the whole world about it. You don't even have to tell all of your family, because they might not all be on the same page with you. So long as your husband at least is on board, that's all you need. You both are in this together. He is your support system. He is going to be the one to be in the birth room with you, or whoever your birth partner is, if you're single or anything like that. Just share it with them. Make sure you have that support that you need, because it is a tough time. It is a challenging time that you really need someone to hold you down, to keep you grounded, and just to keep you encouraged in this period. The next thing that I did was to pray specific prayers. And so with my first daughter being premature, there were certain things that I feel like I wasn't ready for, certain things when it came to birth that I wanted to experience that I didn't experience. And so with this second pregnancy, I prayed for specific things. So in my prayer, I prayed that you know, my water will break and that will be my sign of going to the hospital. I prayed for you know, a specific weight for my baby. I prayed for you know, going full term. And so there were specific things that I asked about this pregnancy, and you know, I feel like the Lord was so faithful and he answered you know, my prayers for me as he saw fit. My water did not break like I wanted to, but you know, I didn't cry over it or anything like that. A lot of other things I prayed for specifically, you know, God gave to me, God answered. And so, you know, ultimately, I prayed for specific things, things I was believing God for, I was trusting in God for, and that was one of the ways that I prepared for it. So if you want your water to break, if that's something you want to experience, pray for it. You know, everyone's faith level is different, everyone's desires are different. So what are the key things that you're looking for with this VBAC? What is it that was with your first pregnancy that you didn't, you know, you didn't witness, or you didn't feel that you want to feel, or you didn't experience that you want to experience? Things like that are, you know, things that you should consider praying about and asking for. Another way that I prepared for this VBAC was to speak God's words over my life. There will be times where you feel doubtful. There will be times where you're scared and nervous and stuff like that. So in those moments, I just spoke God's words over my life. You know what God has said about birth, that I will not pass my fruit before it is due. I'm not going to have this baby earlier than it needs to come. I'm not going to entertain any thought from the enemy. I bind and hold every thought captive, every negative thought captive to the obedience of Christ. My body was made for it. It's just basically affirming myself and just speaking God's words over my life and just encouraging myself, because there will be times that you will doubt it. There will be times that you'll be fearful. There'll be times where the enemy will put things in your mind and make you feel scared and decide to just quit altogether. But just keep reaffirming yourself, just keep speaking positive things over your life, just speak God's words over your life and who He's made you to be. You are a woman and you were built for this. The enemy is going to play tricks on you, going to remind you that Eve was cursed, and so we all have to, you know, be cursed or whatever. No, don't even think that way. Jesus came to break every chain, break every curse, including that curse. And so whatever you pray for and want to see in your birth story, you will see it in the name of Jesus. Another way that I prepared for it was to know that ultimately things were not in my control, that I'm not sovereign overall. You know, I might have some desires, I might want certain things, but at the end of the day, God's will be done. At the end of the day, there are certain things that are beyond my control that I can't do anything about. And so if things are not going the way that, you know, you thought it was going to go, don't fret, don't panic, you know, don't do any of that. At the end of the day, whatever's safe for you, that's what God's going to allow to happen, despite your prayers or whatever. He will honor the desires of your heart, but He cares about your safety and your baby's safety first. And so, you know, don't obsess with things that don't need obsessing over. Just do your part, just pray, just have faith, just, you know, become relaxed and leave everything into God's hands. And the final thing that I'm gonna say is that I did not give in to pressure. I didn't give in to fear. Like, I didn't give up. I remember when we got to the hospital, my husband kind of had the vibe that the doctor wanted me to go do C-section. You know, she made a couple comments that she was kind of alluding to, you know, getting this baby out fast if that's what I wanted to do, or just quickly, or no, just basically alluding to C-section. And honestly, I was so tired at that point that I almost considered it, but I'm so glad my husband was there to remind me of what I prayed for and remind me that, you know, this is what I wanted. VBAC was what I wanted, and so let's just keep pushing and keep going for it. And so I was very glad that I didn't give in to fear and I didn't give in to that subtle pressure that we felt from the doctor. And so, you know, as soon as I got checked in and I got admitted, when the doctor checked me, I was like, what, 3 centimeters dilated? And she was really happy for us, actually. She was like, oh my gosh, like, that's awesome. Like, you're 3 centimeters dilated? That's awesome. And so she herself, honestly, came on board with our VBAC and everything was great. And so don't give in to fear, don't give in to pressure. When you know that it's pressure speaking and not sound advice or health advice the doctor's trying to give you, it's just, you know, just to hurry up. If it's sound advice, of course, go ahead and take it. But if you know that it's out of pressure and out of fear, stick to your guns, stick to your plans, and everything will be fine. All right, guys, that is it for this video. I hope you guys learned a lot from it, and I hope I answered some questions that some of you might have. If you have any more, if there was anything that I didn't touch on, just let me know, and I can answer that for you. All right, guys, I will see you in my next video, and have a great day. Bye-bye.